Hello viewers, I'm John Brace. Normally I'm behind the camera, not in front of it. But today I wanted to talk about a £12 billion contract that councillors have signed between Merseyside Waste Disposal Authority, now called Merseyside Recycling and Waste Authority, and SITA Sembcorp UK Limited. A few weeks ago, as part of the public's rights under the audit, where the public can inspect various invoices and contracts for 3 weeks each year, I requested this particular contract, although as there weren't any payments made on this contract under the last financial year, they first of all classed it as a freedom of information request. Then they got back to me and said, now it's an environmental information regulations request. They did give me a copy of the contract, but all the pricing information was blacked out. However, the strange thing now, after making Freedom of Information and Environmental Information Regulations requests for years and years, is I came across something new in that when they sent me the email back saying this is the public interest test as to why we've redacted certain bits, they referred to the reuse of Public Sector Information Regulations 2005 and basically said at the bottom that if I wanted to republish it or reuse it, I'd have to ask them for a license. Anyway, I looked up the reuse of Public Sector Information Regulations 2005, and yes, they do apply to information that's been given out for Freedom of Information requests or Environmental Information Regulations requests. Anyway, I found out that the reuse of Public Sector Information Regulations 2005 were in fact repealed before the date of their letter. They were repealed on the 18th of July, so they don't apply anymore. But the reuse of Public Sector Information Regulations 2015 do apply, and they contain some changes, which is why I'm making this video. You see, in Regulation, I think it's 5, yeah, Regulation 5 of the reuse of Public Sector Information Regulations 2015 state, these regulations do not apply to documents held by public service broadcasters and their subsidiaries, and other bodies and their subsidiaries, for the purposes of the provision of programme services. Now, if you look up what these definitions actually mean in the Communications Act 2003, right, bodies means any body or association of persons, whether corporate or unincorporate, including a firm, so that could just mean me and Leonora. Now, the definition of program services is a bit more complicated, but the definition of program services means a television program service, the public teletext service, an additional television service, a digital additional television service, a radio program service or sound service provided by the BBC. And then it goes on to define television program means any program with or without sounds which is produced wholly or partly to be seen on television and consists of moving or still images of or of legible text or of a combination of those things. Now, I've checked whether videos on this YouTube channel are being watched on TVs. I'll just have a quick look at my laptop and see. Yes, over the last year there have been 189 views on smart TVs and set-top boxes for TV. So therefore, strangely enough, I come under the definition of, this comes under the definition of television program, and therefore the regulations do not apply to this particular document, so I don't have to ask them for permission to publish it because it's to do with this program service, and that's why I'm recording this. However, on a final note, I'd like to point out that the, shall we say, the principle that every time somebody in the media makes a Freedom of Information request or an Environmental Information Regulations request, before they use that information, they've got to ask for permission from the public body to reuse it and state what purpose it's for, is, well, for anybody in the media who makes a Freedom of Information request and then writes stories on them, is not the way it's done. I don't know if anybody else has heard of these regulations or whether they're going to crop up in future FOI requests, even though I think Well, council would quite like to send a boilerplate text at the end of each reply they send to me saying that I can't use them unless I get the permission under the Reuse of Public Sector Information Regulation 2015, in which case I'll just make another video like this and then it doesn't apply. Anyway, going back to the £12 billion contract between Merseyside Waste Disposal Authority, or now Merseyside Recycling and Waste Authority, and SITA Sembcorp UK Limited. This is an 864-page contract that over the lifetime of the contract they will pay out £12 billion for and relates to, for years and years and years basically, putting Merseyside's rubbish on a train, sending it up to somewhere in the northeast of England, burning it, generating electricity from the rubbish. I'm not sure what happens to the rubbish after they burnt it, but perhaps I need to read the contract better. But I will be publishing the contract along with this video on my website so you can have a look for yourself. On the subject of the information that's blocked out, I'll be looking into whether I'll make a reconsideration under the Environmental Information Regulations request for that information to be revealed, but I'll have to look into detail. Unfortunately, basically the way the contract is worded, it's very unlikely that I'll actually get access to the financial information, but I'll publish the rest of it on my blog so you can have a read to see what your money will be spent on from 2017. The only other thing, or two other things to say about this contract are, firstly, this contract was signed back in 2013, and at that time the government were making various financial incentives to do this kind of thing so that the rubbish didn't go to landfill. But this was one of three projects where the government decided that there were already enough energy from waste contracts to supply our needs for years and years in the future, and they withdrew the £90 million PFI credits for this particular contract. Now, the two other places that were affected by this decision decided to take the government to judicial review. I don't know what happened as a result of that. And finally, the only other thing to point out about this contract is that there were, in the end, two bidders for this contract, one of whom was obviously the successful contractor SITA Sembcorp UK Limited. Now, the unsuccessful bidder sued Merseyside Waste Disposal Authority because they alleged certain things had happened during the tendering process they shouldn't have. And in fact, they even got the court to basically set aside the contract, or set aside basically implementing the contract, until the court case was settled. Now, the court case was eventually settled out of court. The second place contractor basically asked for Merseyside Waste Disposal Authority to pay all the profit they would have got if they'd been awarded the contract. And of course, Merseyside Waste Disposal Authority doesn't have that kind of money, because it would be over £100 million. I can't remember what the estimate was. I think it was something between £100 million and £200 million. So anyway, that's the last thing I wanted to say about this, and I hope you enjoyed this video. And the contract is on my blog. Okay, bye.